press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello, my dear students. In today's class, we shall continue what we saw in the previous class. We have seen the calculation of acceleration of a combined mass. Then we have solved contact force and the tension without considering the friction into account. Now, say, find the acceleration. Of a body taking friction into consideration. See, dear students, whatever the book you follow, there are plenty of books available in the market, even in the network also. And so many teachers will also come into your life also. But the thing is, you must have that basic knowledge what I have given to you in the previous classes. You should be strong in that. With those concepts, now let us understand how to find an acceleration when friction comes into act. We know static friction or just a limiting friction, which is equal to the mu s into n, where n is a normal reaction. And we have studied that the normal reaction and the weight of the body, if you observe, they come in a same line. Then hence I can say the normal reaction is the weight. If a weight is more the normal reaction, so that is equal to mu s into n. This is the first thing that you have to calculate, that is a static friction. It will helps to determine, this static friction helps to determine how much a minimum force that is needed just to move an object. So whenever the external force act onto your body, there is an opposing force, what we call as a friction force. A body just begins to move now. It is not in motion, remember. When a body just begins to move, or you can say slide, you must say there is a requirement of minimum force. How much minimum force I should apply? That is always equal to the static friction or the limiting friction, dear students. That is maximum static friction. So that is given by the formula mu s into n, where n is normal reaction, balances weight of the body, that is mu s into m into g is the minimum force that is just sufficient to just slide an object. Okay, have this in your notebook and also in your mind. Okay. Now, when body slides, or you can say move, what type of friction comes into account? That is mu k, coefficient of kinetic friction. So that is force due to, that is kinetic friction or sliding friction. Sliding, or you can say kinetic friction, that is equal to mu k into n, that is mu k into mg. Whenever you say the body is in motion, move aagta ide, you must apply kinetic friction. So with this, dear students, if I say when a body begins to move, the applied force, how to calculate the applied force, if they ask, just you remove this kinetic friction, that is mu k is equal to mu k, sorry, fk is equal to mu k into mg. This we can call this as opposing force. So therefore, our point of interest is finding the acceleration. So that is net force divided by net mass. So what is the net force here? You must say, sir, applied force, or you can say the forward force minus the opposing force divided by the total mass. So what is the applied force here? F is the applied force, minus what is the opposing force here due to kinetic friction, whole divided by mass of the body, that gives the acceleration when a body slides. A is equal to F minus FK divided by M. We also write like this. This is say applied force F. There is a kinetic friction, that is mu s into n. This is n, this is mg. So that is acceleration is applied force minus mu k into mg divided by m is the formula. Heading I have given, to find the acceleration by taking friction into account. You take that in highlighted words. You must have an awareness that what you are learning from today class, and don't mug up everything. Now, dear students, have a simple problem now. Question is acceleration. Find acceleration. Two kg box. This is applied force, say 10 newton. They give mu k is equal to 0.2 here. Now, what are the forces? Other forces acting on this, when the body begins to move, there is a normal reaction. There is a weight of the body, that is m into g, downward weight. How much you will write? That is 2 into, taking g is equal to 10 meter per second square. Usually 9.8 irutha. For making the calculation easier, we supposed to take 10. So that is 2 into 10. So how much you will get? 20 newton is the weight of the body. And the kinetic, here they have given, say mu k it is, kinetic friction, that is force due to kinetic friction, that is opposing force we need to calculate. What is the opposing force here? Mu s into n, or you can say mu k into n. When the body is sliding, body move aagta ide, ಅಂದರೆ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್, ಇಲ್ಲ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕು. ಬಿ ಥರೋ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಮೂವ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ಆನ್ ಎ ರೋಡ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್, ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್. ನೋ ಸರ್, ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಯೆಟ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಟ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್ ನೌ, ದ motion of the object is not yet started, it is going to be started. Sir, ella meaning onde avaga rest alli ittandre static friction apply madu, illa slide aagta ide move aagta ide illa acceleration calculate madidara andre you must say a kinetic friction. It is that is mu k into n, mu k into m into g. What is mu k here? 0.2 into how much you got here? 20 ಎಷ್ಟಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಸೊ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 2 20 2 40 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, 4 ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ 0.2 0.2 10 2 ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ನಾ ಅಪೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 4 ನ್ಯೂಟನ್. ದ ಅಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 10 ನ್ಯೂಟನ್, is greater than this 4 newton. Sir, there is some net force here, hence the acceleration. Basic formula: net force divided by net mass. Therefore acceleration is equal to applied force minus opposing force divided by mass. Neradad sala baritta idini, bejar aagbedi, nan helidinalla. You can see any books anywhere at any time. You can have any teacher in front of you, but the basic knowledge in your mind. So now that is equal to, so FA, that is how much applied force, 10 Newton minus, what is the opposing force here? 4 Newton divided by, what is the mass of the body given? 2. So that is 6/2. Acceleration of the body is 3 meter per second square. They ask you find the minimum force. What is the minimum force that is required just to move? What they have given here? Static friction. Therefore that minimum force required is equal to mu s into n, that is the static friction, maximum static friction. So what is mu s here? 0.3 into, what is n here? M into G. This is basic, dear students. N and weight of the body. So now, 0.3 into 3, that is point, sorry, mu is 0.3, M is, mass is 3, into 10. So how much you will get? 9 Newton is the minimum force that is needed. Minimum force that is needed to move an object. Okay, with this, let us take this as one and let us have this subdivisions on this problem. Subdivision means, can we say here that by applying this 3 kg, having static friction is equal to 0.3, if I apply 5 Newton, if I apply 5 Newton, does a body move? What is the acceleration of this particle? If in the same problem, same concept, in your book or anywhere, if you see this problem, this type of problem, he is asking what is the acceleration of the body. Many of the students, they, what they feel is, acceleration is a force by mass, that is 5/3. So 5/3 meter per second square is the answer. Many students may feel, without having that basic knowledge, there is some opposing force. This applied force should exceed the applied, the applied force should exceed the friction that is developed. What is the minimum force that is needed here? Then because of this static friction, the minimum force required is 9 Newton, but how much they are given here? 5 Newton. This 5 Newton is less than the limiting friction. Body cannot move. Body does not move. Therefore, acceleration of the particle is zero. Atwa acceleration of that box is zero because static friction is much greater than the applied force. This is because static friction is much greater than the applied force. So what is the maximum static friction applied here? 9 Newton. That is greater than the applied force. How much here? 5 Newton. Hence body never moves. Again, subdivision, dear students, I am continuing the same to get confident in this. I am repeating the same. Suppose if I apply 8 Newton, again the same thing, you will get Fs here, mu s is 0.3 here. So what is acceleration is, again 8 Newton is less than the static friction, body does not move, therefore acceleration is zero. Opposing force is more here, that is Fs is maximum or more compared to applied force. Friction, opposing force jaasti ide, body move aglikke bidalla, friction jaasti idane, body doesn't move at all, therefore acceleration of the body is zero. If I say 9 Newton, body just begins to move. But still body not in motion. Why? Because if I say F minus here Fs divided by M, again that becomes what here? Zero. But body now begins to move if I exceed this 9 Newton. Many students may ask, sir, if I apply exactly 9 Newton, here also the opposing force is also 9 Newton here. When they are balancing, the net acceleration is zero, means body is at rest, still it is at rest, but begins to move. Now if I apply 10 Newton, third point, same, dear students, normal reaction, weight of the body, here this 10 Newton is greater than the static friction, body slide now, body will slide, will move with an acceleration that is equal to applied force minus the static friction divided by the mass. Applied force minus opposing force. Iga tumba strong adira ant ankondo avaga when the body begins to move ant heladaga, now there is a question of what? Kinetic friction. When body begins to move, then there is Fk that is equal to mu k into n. They must give that mu k is equal to, say I have given 0.3, they may give say 0.4 now. Point 0.3 it is. Let us take this. I have written wrong. Mu k, that is kinetic friction, will be less here. So that is equal to, how much you will get? 0.2. I am changing the value. Kinetic friction is lesser than the static friction. 0.2. Then I write 3 into 10 here. So that is 6 Newton you will get. So therefore the applied force, now it becomes now Fk now. When the body start to begin, when it is in motion, you must have kinetic friction, dear students. Applied force is 10 minus opposing force. Nodi example idella perfect aadmele bega bega calculate maadkollike idu nimge opposing force anta gottaayidu. Starting friction becomes kinetic friction anta kodirtare. A kinetic friction anta kottaaga calculate maadkollike mu s into m into g, mu k m into g, mass est kodidare 3, value of g est irutte 10, 10 into fraction multiply markovodi. 10 into 0.2 becomes what? 2. 2 into 3, 6 and 3. Direct like I repeat. Mu k kodirthara. 0.2 kodirthara. G value is 10. 10 into 0.2. This is decimal point. That is a pure integer. 0.2 into 10. Test 2. 2 multiplied with what? Mass. Test 1. 6. 10 minus 6 divided by, what is the mass of the body? 3. So we will get 4 by 3 meter per second square is the acceleration. So last, dear students, one more example here. So with this, looking at this, very first thing is, they have given mu k here, you must say opposing forces, mu k m into g, as I told, 0.1 becomes a 10 here, 10 into 10 becomes what, 100 newton here, which is much greater than 20 newton, body does not move, therefore that is acceleration of the body is 0. Again, they are asking the acceleration. What is the acceleration of the body? Now again, as we given μs here, they must calculate the maximum static friction, or you say limiting friction, μs into n, μs into mg. As I told, μs is 0.2, 0.2 into 10, that is 2, 2 to the 4, 4 newton, which is greater than the applied force. 4 newton is greater than the applied force, the body begins, therefore you must say the acceleration is net force. Net force divided by the mass of the body, and here don't worry that I have to write mu k here. No, the applied force is greater than this, just extract this. Extract madi. Yes, Taito? Applied force 10 minus 4 divided by m. So that is acceleration is equal to 6 divided by 2, you will get 3 meter per second square. Dear students, with this basic knowledge, you can enter and try any type of problems. Now, the next concept, taking friction into account, study of motion of object on inclined plane. Take a heading, motion of object. Motion of an object on an inclined plane. Again, concepts remains the same here. Net force, applied force minus opposing force divided by the net mass. Basic, that is Newton's second law. A is equal to F divided by M. And have this in your mind that, again, net force divided by total mass. Means, again, the applied force, don't feel bad. Applied force minus opposing force divided by the total mass. In order to find an acceleration, net force, applied force minus opposing force divided by total mass. If friction doesn't come, means opposing force is zero. Either basic nan pittukondu vidyarthigale neevu eshtu lekka ashtu lekkagalanna madta hogabodu. ಆಯಿತು ಸರ್, You take the diagram along with me. Inclined plane and the takshana. So this is AB, let us say height of an inclined plane. You must take along with me, very, very essential. So BC is the base. Theta is the angle of inclination. Theta is angle of inclination. Means we must say that theta is an angle of inclination. Sometimes we call this as angle of repose, R-E-P-O-S-E. Angle of repose is an angle at which a body of mass m just begins to move. It is the angle of an inclined plane at which a body, or you can say an object just begins to move. When I say body just begins to move, there you must say that there is some static friction or a limiting friction, that is mu s into n, dear students, mu s into m into g comes into picture whenever you say body begins to slide. Theta is called angle of repose. ఈతర హారిజాంటల్ ఇది ఎంత అనుకో, ఇది ఇది డస్టర్, ఇది ప్లేన్ అంత అనుకో, అర్థం మాట్లాడుకోలేక ఇది నీగ హింగ్ మూవ్ మాడతా ఇది బీళ్తా ఇలా ఏనిదే ఫ్రిక్షన్ జాస్తి ఇదే డస్టర్ మూవ్ ఆగ్తా ఇలా మూవ్ ఆగ్తా ఇలా మూవ్ ఆగ్తా ఇలా కంటా ఇదియా మూవ్ ఆగ్తా ఇలా సార్ ఈగేనా సార్ స్లైడ్ ఆగ్తా ఇదే నోడో అంటుకోబిట్టిదే బిత్తు అర్థ అవుతారా రఫ్ రోజురింద సిన్స్ the object is rough and my surface is also rough, so what happens now, there is a static friction here. Even this is initial duster kaanta idena pa kaanta ide sir in the yellow color idena idu idu horizontal ide inclined idu angle of inclination with horizontal theta artham ankolleki move maartta idu move anta leka friction jaasti ide ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಭಾಳ ಬೇಕಾಯಿತು ಅಂಟ್ಕೊಂಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ ಅದು ಹಾಂ ಬಿತ್ತು ದಿ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಅಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ ಬಿಗಿನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪೋಸ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅ ಫ್ರೀ ಬಾಡಿ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಬಾಡಿ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಮ್ you know first the weight of the body and or you can say weight first acceleration kalpadana first let us find the acceleration now always acceleration due to gravity acts down g always acts down now this g has to be resolved into two components one I use a color chalk piece here this g has to be resolved into two components that is one along the inclined plane and another one perpendicular to the inclined plane now as this is theta here this is theta by geometry this is 90 this angle is 90 minus theta since this is a 90 this angle is also is equal to theta. Artha aayitu. Now this theta, if I have this a rectangle here, constructing a rectangle for better understanding. Now this becomes what, adjacent side. Andre y component adjacent adjacent antashna yav baribeku ant helithu g cos theta helkottidhi adjacent idre theta ge idu yav lenagutte opposite agutte this is g here this one theta ge opposite idre opposite bandre sine function barutte and these two are equal rectangle alli opposite sides equal irutte therefore this function becomes what g sin theta here. Be careful in writing the components of what? G. G is a vector quantity. So I am resolving this G into two rectangular components. That is, along y direction G cos, along x direction is G sin theta. Therefore, dear students, along an inclined plane, after writing this, suppose if I have an object like this, they may give in this diagram also. The same thing I am repeating for better understanding. If they have given theta like this, both are same here. Here let us say object of mass m, object of mass m begins to slide now. What is, with what acceleration it is sliding down anta kelidre namma nimma kelsa ishtapayiga sir g sin theta anta helbeku. ಸರ್ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಯಾಕೆ ಬಂತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಪರ್ಪೆಂಡಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾ ರಿಸಾಲ್ವಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಪೊನೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಾವ್ ಜಿ? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ, ಅಡ್ಜಸೆಂಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್, ಜಿ ಕಾಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ whenever you have an inclined plane. I have written acceleration. When you know acceleration, by Newton's second law, mass into acceleration, for this if you multiply with m, it becomes what, weight of the body. Hence for this g sin theta, mg sin theta is a component of weight along inclined plane. Here mg cos theta. Okay, let us have these two diagrams separately. Take these two as a separate diagram. Drawing rectangle showing the rectangular components. This is one. This is two. Arrow mark must be there. This one is G here. Okay, now dear students, I have not taken friction into account now. From this diagram, normal reaction is a force which is always perpendicular to the surface, surface on which the object is placed. Object of mass m is placed on this, and this normal reaction is perpendicular to the surface on which object is kept. Looking at the diagram, whenever you say normal reaction is, as in the earlier, we must suppose to say that normal reaction is the downward weight. Normal reaction is the downward means what? E normal lige balance mat mg alla n lige balance mada force yavdu ond kelidre mg cos theta irutte. That is n is equal to mg cos theta. Normal reaction is mg cos theta. I am balancing the weight of the body. Remember carefully, whenever we need acceleration, g cos theta, that is perpendicular to inclined plane. G sine theta is a component of acceleration along the inclined plane. And many students may get confused. Sir, shall we take G sine theta or G cos theta? That is the problem. For equating the normal reaction, G cos theta will come into picture by the geometry. Since N is balancing the mg cos theta, N is equal to mg cos theta. Body is sliding down. Yava directional move aagta ide adu nodko. That is down the inclined plane. Andra object na kela elkon baror yaro, with what acceleration the body is moving. That is g sin theta. That is among GLA, sorry, when g is resolved into two components, g cos theta and g sin theta, g sin theta is the acceleration by which body is sliding down. Okay, fine. Now in this problem, in the same problem, what I suggest you is, say body is moving down the plane, and here I just take this as body is moving up the plane. As we have written two diagrams, let us analyze both the things in one page. Heading barkandidira. Here, body sliding down. Here, body move upward. Means here is the acceleration here. Here is the acceleration. Now be confident here. Whether body moves down the plane or up the plane, be careful about these basic things, dear students. I repeat this, those words what I said. Whether you refer any books, any number of books in front of you, you will purchase, I know. We know. Whatever the book you have in front of you, and whatever the teacher that you will have, you will come into picture in future. Any teacher, if you come in front of you, but you should be strong in this. And we teachers cannot go beyond these concepts. Means you should be strong in this. Yes, sir. Whether body move down or up the inclined plane, this acceleration g sine theta is always directed down. Fine. Next, taking friction into account. We have to study with the friction. Now, if there is no friction, this is enough. This is enough. But many cases we will have a friction into account. Means when the body is sliding down, friction force is what? Opposing force. That opposing force. If I say body just begins, slide aagta illa, just begins to move. So sliding down idhe andre enta friction barutte? Kinetic friction barutte. Okay, I will write kinetic friction. As I written, slides down, I have written, that is opposing force is Fk, that is equal to mu k into n. What is n here, dear students? In both the cases I said that n is equal to normal reaction. That normal reaction is mu k into mg cos theta. Sorry, mg, downward way. Mg cos theta. Okay? Yes, sir. So when you come into this second diagram here, dear students, don't worry. If I written force here it is, I have written acceleration. Then again I am repeating you, if you need acceleration, g sin theta. Since I am balancing the frictional force here, therefore I need mg sin theta. Here, weight I need mg cos theta. Okay, you have taken. I think you understood this, what I am changing the words here. Here, I am changing this as mg sin theta is the downward weight. Downward weight, or you can say downward acceleration is g sin theta, and I said that is friction I have to write. Now the body is moving up. Dear students, be careful about this. When body slides up or down, acceleration is always directed down. But friction will change here. Now as the body is moving up, there is a opposing force, that is kinetic friction will come downward. Kinetic friction is downward. Okay, with this, can we say what is the acceleration that is produced when the body moves up and down the plane? Here, you must say like this. Here is the downward acceleration. That is the force up in which the body is moving down. Moving down. Here, the acceleration with which body is moving up. Okay, dear students, I need a space. Can I write here? Can I write at this place now? Here, acceleration is net acceleration. Here, what happens now? G sin theta is downward here. Or you can say net force, I can write. Force required is, that is M into A. Acceleration. What is the acceleration formula? As we said, net force divided by net mass. Take this. Total force divided by net mass. So here mg sin theta is downward. Is the downward force. Opposing force is what? Nu k into n. So therefore, this acceleration is what I can write, mg sin theta minus mu k n. Mu k n divided by m. Understood? Idu artha agide anta tilkobodu. Yes, sir. Now again here this acceleration is, again previous what we have studied, the same thing I am writing. Net force. Total force divided by total mass. Here, what is the net force acting here? Here, both forces are acting downward. Again, once again, I'm explaining. Body is moving up. Opposing force is downward. Means sliding force. That is, kinetic friction is downward. So, I can write both forces. Net force is mg sin theta plus fk divided by mass of the body. So, with this, dear students, you have taken the diagrams. Hence, I just remove this. Say this is downward. Either up the plane. This is down the plane. Down the inclined plane. This is up the inclined plane. So what is your next response here? Sir, I can write my words. Mg sin theta minus, I have said sliding. Therefore, I have mu k. That is, write mu k. What is n here? Mg cos theta divided by mass here. So m cancels, dear students. Therefore, A becomes equal to, I said, g sin theta minus m is cancelled here. Mu k into g cos theta. So rudi madkanta practice madta down the plane ide andre, if object is moving down the plane, just subtract this mu k, or just subtract f k. Now if it is body is moving, sliding up ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ಭಯ ಕೊಡಿಬೇಕ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಬೇಡಿ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ಇಫ್ ಎ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್, ಬಾಡಿ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್, ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೂವ್ಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಆರ್ ಡೌನ್, ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಸೊ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಈಸ್ ಡೌನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಫ್ ಕೆ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡೌನ್ ವರ್ಡ್, ಬೋತ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆ್ಯಡೆಡ್. ಅದನ್ನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮೈಂಡಲ್ಲಿ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಅಂತ ಬಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಇವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎಮ್ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಮ್ಯೂ ಕೆ ಎಮ್ ಜಿ ಕಾಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎಮ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಂಟ್ರನ್ಸ್, ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಸೇ ಸರ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್, ಸರ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಪ್ಲಸ್ since already is in motion, body is slide aagta ide, move aagta ide andre, sir I need to write mu k g cos theta. G anta common irutte vidyarthigale, g common irutte, nim kelsa sin theta plus mu k cos theta. So you know bala fast age g is equal to sin theta plus cos theta irutte, sin plus cos irutte, mu k multiply maadu. And when body move up the plane, idike when the body moves down the plane and dakshna common a down ant baridre g common tago nan heltene sin theta minus cos theta irutte multiplied with what mu k when body slides or move at all, that is kinetic friction. Dear students, I think you have understood very well and the tilkanda one lekkana nimge sahaya maadana one or two lekkana nimge ondu athwa eradu sakashtu idave eshtara lekka maadu ee basic concept na chenaga strong agirbeku anta namma aase. So dear students, question is this. Question. Compare the time taken by the object when it slides down the inclined plane, first when the surface is smooth, and next on the rough surface, okay, understood. Compare the time taken by the body when it slides on an inclined plane, first on a smooth surface and then on a rough surface. Let us take T1 on the smooth surface. And Dakshina, you must say mu k is 0, no opposing force, dear students, fk is equal to 0. Let us have this diagram in front of your book. Artha maadkolike il slide aagta hai, it is sliding down the plane. Now here friction is 0. Again, as I told, what is the acceleration due to gravity now? You must write, let us say theta is the angle of inclination. Don't ask anybody. Theta is the angle of inclination at which the body begins to move. This theta is called angle of repose. And this distance on an inclined plane, let us take this as S here. When the object is given, when it slides, it has some initial velocity. That initial velocity is zero. Then as you know from the basic equation of kinetics, S is equal to ut plus of at square. Here the object is moving down. Moving down means g is always negative. Here S is equal to, this is zero. Downward displacement, S is coming down. Nodappa sarai nodukkole. As the box is coming down, 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 this S goes on decreasing, decreasing, decreasing. ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇದೆಯಪ್ಪ, ಇದು ಹೈಟ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿದೆ, ಒಂದು 10 meters ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೋ. ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿದೆ. ಈಗ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗ್ಬೋದು? 8 meters. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಬಂತು 4 meters. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬಂತು ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್, ಎಷ್ಟಾಗ್ಬೋದು? 2 meters. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಬೋದು 1 meter. ಆಸ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಡೌನ್ 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 ಡೌನ್, ಎಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಡೌನ್ 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 ಡೌನ್, ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್. ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಆಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೈನ್ ಕನ್ವೆನ್ಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ ಜಾಮೆಟ್ರಿ, ಅಬೋ ದಿ ಆರಿಜನ್ ಆಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಆಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್, ಬಿಲೋ ದಿ ಆರಿಜನ್ ಆಲ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಆಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್. ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ acceleration is always downward, means it is along the negative y, always negative y direction. Therefore this a is taken as negative here, that is minus. Here acceleration I take along the downward the plane is minus g sin theta. Don't confuse this minus sign, always down, g is negative. Therefore applying this, suppose you ulta nodida, if the body is thrown up, the distance become 1 into the 2 have 4 at 8 at, height is go on increasing idre. Suppose if this body is moving up the plane idre, you must take displacement as positive, increase in height positive, decrease in height negative. Okay, so increase in velocity positive, decrease in velocity negative. Gottu sir idella. ಈ ಜಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಆಗಲೇ ಹೇಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಯಾರನ್ನೇ ಕೇಳೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೈನ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಇದೆ, ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಐ ರೈಟ್ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಇಂಟು ಟಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಈ ಮೈನಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್, ಇದನ್ನು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀಯ, 2 into s ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟಿ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಟಿ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ 2s ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಫ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್, ಹಿ ಆರ್ ಶಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಆಸ್ T1 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ T2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್. ಹಿಯರ್ 2s ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ಡ್. ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ಟೂ ರೇಷಿಯೋಸ್, 2s ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ಡ್, ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಇದೆ. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ T1 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ, ದೆನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ g sin theta minus mu k cos theta is the answer. ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬರೆದ್ರಿ ಸರ್, ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊತೀನಿ. ಇಫ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್, ವೇರ್ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಝೀರೋ, ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್. ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ಆನ್ ದ incline, when the inclined surface is rough here, so on the rough surface, on a rough surface, that means mu k is not equal to zero, then acceleration becomes what acceleration becomes? G, as I told, g sin theta. How much you'll get? Body is sliding down, that is minus heading mu k g cos theta, what I have written. Again, with this basic knowledge, no need to explain again here. T2 is equal to, that is 2s divided by a, you will get a, 2s divided by a. Instead of a, how much I should write here? G sin theta minus mu k g cos theta. ಎರಡು ರೇಷೋ ತಗೋಬೇಕಪ್ಪ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ರೇಷೋ ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ 2s ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. T inversely proportional ಇದೆ, ಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ T1 by T2 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಜಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋ. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, sine theta minus nu k cos theta divided by sine theta. This is how you have to understand. ಇದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸೈಡಿಗೆ ನೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಯು ಟಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಟಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರಲ್ಲಿ ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಝೀರೋ ಮೈನಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಟಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟು ಎಸ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಅಂತ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳು ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇ 2s divided by a ಅಂತ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇಲ್ಲ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಇದೇ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ನ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಟನ್ ನೀಟ್ಲಿ ಕಾಪಿ ಇಟ್ ನೀಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾನರ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಪರೇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ ರಫ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಇದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೈನ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಲ್ಲಿ ರಫ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಇದೆ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಅನ್ಕೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಡೌನ್ ವಿತ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ದ್ಯಾರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಫ್ ಕೆ ಮ್ಯೂ ಕೆ ಇಂಟು ಎನ್ ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪೋಸಿಂಗ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಅ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಎಮ್ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಓಕೆ ನನ್ನ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಅಂದರೆ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಡೀಪ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಈಗಲೇ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಎಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಯು ಟಿ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಟಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಝೀರೋ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋ ಇದನ್ನು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋ ಡೌನ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಮೋಷನ್ ಇದೆ ಡೌನ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಇದೆ ಮೈನಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟು ಎ ಟಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಟಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಟು ಎಸ್ ಬೈ ಎ ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟು ಎಸ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಇದನ್ನು ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಪಕ್ಕ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದೆಯಾ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಎಂಟ್ರನ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಇಷ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ಬರೀಬೇಕೇನು ಸರ್ ಬೇಡ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ಯಾ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಟಿ ಒನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಟಿ ಟು ಅಂದರೆ ಇದು ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸು ಇದು ರಫ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಅಷ್ಟು ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಷೋ ತೊಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಟು ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು ದ ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗ ಇದು ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಆನ್ ರಫ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸು ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಆನ್ ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನೆನ್ಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಎ ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಲ್ಲಿ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ರಫ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಲ್ಲಿ ಆಪೋಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾಗೆ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಅದೊಂದು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರ್ಬೇಕು ಮತ್ತೆ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಸಾರಿ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಡೌನ್ ಅಂತಂದಾಗ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವ ಕಡೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಪ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಿನಗೇನು ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೈನಸ್ ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅಷ್ಟೆ ಮೈನಸ್ ಹೇಳೋ ನ್ಯೂ ಕೆ ಜಿ ಕಾಸ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಈ ಥರ ಫಾಸ್ಟಾಗಿ ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಲೆಟಸ್ ಡೂ ದ ಟೂ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇಯರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಆಗಲೇ T1 by T2 is equal to sine theta minus mu k cos theta divided by sine theta. Now question is this, dear students. Same question. If mu k, or they give static friction that is equal to 0.2, and angle of repose is say 30 degree or say 45 degree you can say. Find T1 by T2 when body, first one, slides down the inclined plane second body, just you can say just slides down, just slides up the plane, up the inclined plane method. ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಂತಪ್ಪ ಈಗೇನು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನೇ ವಿತ್ ಡೇಟಾ, ವಿತ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್, ಬಟ್ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಅಂತ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಸೇ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಈಸ್ ಡೌನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಅಂತ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಸೇ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮ್ಯೂ ಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲ್ರೇಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮ್ಯೂ ಕೆ ಬರೀಲೇಬೇಕಪ್ಪ. ಹೌದು ಸರ್, ಇದು ಥೀಟಾ 45 degrees ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಬಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಅಂತ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ನಾವು ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್, ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೈ ಸೈಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಹಿಯರ್ here sin 45 means in all the cases we have sin theta here, sin theta that is sin 45 degree is equal to cos 45 degree that is equal to how much here 1/√2 ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಸರ್. ಅಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ನಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕೆಲಸ ಈಗಲ್ಲಿ ಡೌನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ, ಎಂದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್, ಮೊದಲು ಅಪ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಬರ್ದಿದ್ದೀನಲ್ವಾ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಡೌನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಪ್ಪ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್ ಡೌನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೀನಲ್ವಾ, ಓಕೆ ಸಾರಿ ಡೌನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಇದೆ, ದೆನ್ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಫ್ ಕೆ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ನಾವ್ T1/T2 ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೈನ್ 45 ನಾವ್ 1/√2 ಮೈನಸ್ ಮ್ಯೂ ಕೆ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ 0.2 1/√2 ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೈನ್ 45 1/√2 ವಾಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ 1/√2 ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ T1/T2 ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ 1/√2 ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, 1 - 0.2 ಉಳಿಯುತ್ತೆ. ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ T1/T2 ಈಸ್ 0.8. ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಬೋದಾ? ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಡೌನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್, ಡೌನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾವು ಅಪ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಅಪ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಜಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಎಕ್ಸಲರೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡೌನ್ವರ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಎಫ್ ಕೆ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡೌನ್ವರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ಯೂನ್ small change that you can make out, dear students, we make this as a plus here, this also plus, 1/√2 gets cancelled, 1 + 0.2, so you will get a root of 1.2. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಮೂತ್, ಆಮೇಲೆ ರಫ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಝೀರೋ, ಫ್ರಿಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಝೀರೋ, ದೆನ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ರಫ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಲ್ಲೇ ಅದರಲ್ಲೇ ಸಬ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್, ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೌನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್, ಅದರ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೌನ್, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ದಟ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ 0.8 ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ನಾವ್, T1/T2, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ 1.2. I will give one homework for you that you just saw. Find the coefficient of find mu s. Find mu s when a body just slides down the inclined plane, means just begins to move. When body just begins to move, we must show that mu s is equal to tan theta. You must get the answer mu s is equal to tan theta when a body just begins to move. Dear students, just try maadi. ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ನಾಳೆ ಕ್ಲಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು, ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್.